Hello, it is Las Vegas Lori Ballen, and today I'm going to make you another video as part of my 365 Days of KW Command series. Today we're going to create a postcard design. So on the left-hand side, we're going to go down to this little tablet and click Designs. Now, Designs is actually one of my favorite applets inside KW Command. I think it has a tremendous amount to offer. And when you first log into Designs, you're probably going to see a blank white screen. Instinctively, you might click up here because you assume the templates are in there, like I did, most of us do. And these are actually just filters that help display only items that you have created, the designs you've created from templates in that category. So this is where our email is stored, designs, this is where our landing page designs are, our social designs, print designs, agent site designs, and video designs, but only after we create them. So when you first log in, this screen is going to be blank. You're going to go down to this plus sign on the bottom right, click it, and now you have options. So today we want to create a postcard, and to create a postcard in Designs, we're going to go to print. Now here you can actually import photos and text from a listing if you'd like, but I will tell you that you can also pull from the KWLS listings once we get in there, and you can also upload an image in there as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and take us straight into Designs, into our postcard options. Okay, now as you can see, you've got lots of templates. By default, it dropped me into the My App. So if I want to send postcards to promote my app, I've got options here. I can send jumbo postcards, I can send large postcards, and I can send standard postcards. And each one of these is going to have a front and a back. But let's just say you have a new listing, which is the one that I just did a write-up on today. And we're going to go ahead and do a postcard for our listing. So I'm going to go down here to for sale. And then you'll see here you have door hangers, flyers, standard postcards, trifolds, bifolds, and other sizes of bifolds. So we're just going to go ahead and do a standard postcard. So you've got lots of options here in your for sale. There's 57 in total, including all the different options. So it's not 57 postcards, but it's 57 design templates in this section. You can also look at your just listed. Remember, you have to just go to postcards. So this one has portrait postcards. Those are nice. And then we have standard postcards. So it's really going to depend on what you want to create. You'll be able to change the text, the pictures, and everything. So we're going to go ahead to for sale. I'm going to choose standard postcards, and I am obsessed with this new design here, with these new really clean ones. I'm going to click use. Okay, I just love this one. All right, so here's what you have in design. You actually have two pages, okay? Two individual separate pages. The front is a page, and then if you look down here at the bottom, the back is also a page. So you're gonna wanna go in and edit both of them, okay? So to edit the back, you're gonna put a message here. You're going to edit this. So to edit anything, just simply click on it, and wherever you want to start typing, you can. Now, if you're not doing a mail merge with these postcards, you might want to change that to something like just listed. Okay. Now, if you don't want this long message right here, you can actually just take that out. And we can drop in a bullet point list, let's just say. Three bedroom, pool, in the Vistas neighborhood, 1,500 square feet. Let's see. 1 mile from elementary school. 1 block from high school. Whatever it is that you want to point out about that house, you can do here. Okay. And then if you want, you can also add, let's just say maybe we want to put that there, but maybe we do want a little paragraph up here. So simply click here to add another section. Hold on, let's see. Text. All right, subtitle, there we go. Drag that up. And if you don't like the size of that, you can adjust it here. 18 points, 12 points. You can also change this, the size of this as well, by dropping down and changing the fonts there. Okay, so you play with this until you get it where you want it. Keeping in mind that right here, you're going to have a label, okay? So we're not going to want to cut, we're not going to want to go too far over. We're going to want to leave a nice clean address here. Now, creating this postcard design at the end, you're going to have the option to download this as a JPEG, as a PNG file, as a PDF, and you can then print it yourself. You can do mail merge with labels and print and send. You can send this off to your favorite printer, or you can create a direct mail campaign inside KW Designs and send it out through Real Mailer. So you've got lots of options. And in another video, I'm going to show you how to do the direct mail campaign. So once you have this, you can go over here and say, okay, I need to change this headshot image. So go to the right. What you do is you click on the image that you want to replace. Find the image you want to replace it with and click that little, those little round arrows. Okay. Now, if I wanted to, I could edit this too. See, I can drag that up and say, you know, I really only want that to be my head in that image like she had. So put it where you want it. Okay. And then just make sure you're not cut off there. And then you would change this information. Okay, you can drop your own logos in here if you have one. So I'll go up here to logos. And I want to replace that one with this one. Whoops. No, not going to let me do it that way. Okay, so we'll just drop that in. And then I would put that wherever I want it. This is all drag and drop, so it's relatively simple. And then let's do the same thing with that DBA logo. And just shrink them down to however you want them in there. Okay, and then make whatever other edits you want. On the front, same thing here. You can just change the address of that listing. And now we want to go down to the bottom of this page. So let me open this all the way here. There we go. So did you see what I did down here? There's pages. So if I need to get to the whole image, I just take that little arrow and toggle it like that so it drops to the bottom. And then if I want to go from the front to the back, I can simply click that 1 and 2. Okay. Now, one of the things I like to do is I like to put my own picture on top of a postcard. And the reason why I do that is because I still believe, unless you're spending a ton of money on your logo to get your logo recognized, your face and identity is still probably your best marketing tool as a real estate agent. Okay, so I am going to go ahead and drop that in. Now, what I've done is I have removed the background of my photo and I saved it as a PNG file so that I can simply lay that over any image that I want to and keep my branding active. Now, there are several ways to remove the background off of your photo. If you have Canva, I've got a tutorial video that shows you how to remove the background. If you're using PicMonkey, you now can remove the background. And there's another website called remove.bg, remove.bg, where you can simply upload any photo you want and then click to remove the background, and it will remove the background. And then you just store it right here. Okay, nice and easy. All right, so you would go in here and make whatever changes you want to make simply by clicking and just backing out whatever, you know, you want to change. Once you have this postcard the way you want it, it's very simple now to save. The first thing you want to do is change this file name. So this would be 123 Spruce Road Postcard. Okay. Now remember that you technically have two images. You have one and two. So you'll have 123 Spruce Road Postcard image one and then image two. And that will allow you with any postcard mail out company to upload each individual file. You also have the ability to save this as a PDF in a single file, which I'll show you in a moment. So we've renamed it. Up here, you can save it. So I'm going to go to File, Save. You can show the grid. See there, when you're designing. You can also manage the bleed of the postcard here. So you have all of these elements when you are designing. You can also check the print quality. Okay, now we get a little error. Oops, error is gone. Okay, so we're good to go. So I would go back up here to File, deselect, show the grid. This looks great. And I'm going to go to Save. Okay, now if you wanted to do any more design elements on here, right here, you can add drawings, you can add shapes, you can add frames, and you could add text. Okay, very easy. All right. Now, I'm going to go ahead and download this. So we go up here to the little arrow, and we go to download. Okay, from here, you can download this as a JPEG. You can get it as a PNG. You can play with all your publish settings here. Use the manual bleed, automatic bleed by mirroring edges, publish with cut marks, download as a zip file, downloaded as a CMYK PDF only. So whatever your printer is telling you, you need to give them. This is where you have all those options, okay? Same with JPEG. You can also download a thumbnail of this, a web size image, a mobile image, download a zip file. And then all the way on the right, you have Get PDF. So if you are able to use the PDF, you can actually save all designs. And then you can select to download in range from 1 to 2, high resolution print quality, whatever published settings you want, and then start the download. And then what it'll do is it actually downloads a PDF that has both images in the single file. And I'll show it to you here so you can see. So it looks like that. So whatever it is that you need to download, that this is how you download it. That is how easy it is to create a postcard in KW Designs. Stay tuned for the next video where I show you how to set up a direct mail campaign using this postcard.